When we talk about the Purdue experience, the word family often comes to mind first. In the case of Purdue graduate and astronaut Jerry Ross, that's a concept close to his heart. He met his wife Karen at Purdue, and their daughter Amy also is a graduate. When we dedicate Armstrong Hall, we'll open a special room named in his parents' honor. Listen to what Jerry has to say about his time on campus and what he's been doing since graduating.
I was, as a young person, very impressed and excited about flying in space and the opportunities that might be presented in future years. I had built scrapbooks about flying in space, and I had read about everything I could get. In fact, all my aunts and uncles knew that I was excited about it, so they would cut out and preserve for me newspaper and magazine articles. And I read all those, and many of them, since I was in Indiana, focused on Purdue engineers and scientists that were involved in the very early years of the program. And so I knew a lot, and then when the first satellites were launched during my fourth grade year in school, I decided there, then and there in my fourth grade year, that I was going to go to Purdue, become an engineer, and get involved in our country's space program. Purdue gave me the tools that I needed, and it also helped to open a lot of doors, because the previous people who had gone to Purdue and graduated and then gone out into the Air Force and industry had done an excellent job as well before me. So I was welcomed with open arms, because they recognized the quality of the Purdue education. But at the same time, it was a two-edged sword, because since all those other people had performed very well, I was expected to do so as well. So it gave me the opportunities, and gave me a little bit of a rope, if you will, to hang myself, but fortunately, I think I avoided most of those obstacles. Flying in space is like having your cake and being able to eat it. Doing a spacewalk is having your cake and ice cream with cherries on top and whipped cream and the nuts and the whole nine yards. It is the ultimate space experience. There's none better than that. To be able to be outside and literally from ear to ear in your faceplate of your helmet, you can see the Earth if you're looking that direction with no encumbrances, no windows, nobody else's face up in the windows, no nothing. I mean, you're in your own little spaceship, the little spacecraft you call your spacesuit, and it's just the most incredible experience. I can literally remember on my second flight where I was doing spacewalks, I was up on the end of the mechanical arm, and the people inside were doing other things, and they told me just to take a break. And I can literally remember just kind of leaning back and looking at the deep space, the universe, and seeing all the stars out there and thinking to myself, you know, I'm doing exactly what God designed me to do. And for an engineer to have that kind of a sensation or feeling is kind of weird, kind of special. But I really did feel like I was out there doing exactly what I had been intended to do, using my brain and using my hands and my body to do physical things outside, just like I was supposed to do. I really owe a lot to Purdue for what I've been able to achieve and do throughout my career. I think my wife would feel the same way as all of my other friends who went to Purdue. It's a very special place. It's a very friendly place. It's a very warm place. And it brings back nothing but good memories, other than maybe having to take all those darn tests.
Jerry is a wonderful example of the innovation and dedication we see in our students and staff every day. Through them, Purdue University is making an impact across the nation and around the globe.